Yeah. Shout out to everybody out there. Stolen from Africa TV. This is Infinite Lockdown Entertainment. You already know what it is. Okay, from the very beginning, I started out with a group called Ghetto Concept. Easy on the motion, on the beat was locomotion. 9 to 4 we here and 9 to 5 we gone. Stripes upon stripes with on the boss without the lights, the LA lights, so that's the biggest baits glaring in the nights. The hike too tight with a squeezer. Should I say these or the freeze that makes me guess the sneeze and allergies? We were very successful at that time. I considered, you know, 2 Juno Awards. And then I went on to be a solo artist. I dropped Gotta Get Mine, which was very successful for me. About to feel the future is on. From dust to thorn, these horny hookers selling half of their fluff. This life is parallel to hell, but in these days it's a must. And then I continued to pursue my career, winning 2 Much Music Video Awards, and it just kept getting better and better. I mean, a lot of things came in the way at the time. My mind wasn't 100% into music. It was also on the block. So that kind of interfered and brought me down. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Got caught up in the system. But I'm back. I'm back in a big way too. So look out. New material, 2009, Infinite. I think a lot of things changed since then. I mean, we used to sell records back then. We used to sell CDs. Distribution was a lot different. Now you got online distribution. You got iTunes. So you know what I mean? Marketing is much different now because of that online distribution. So I mean, you gotta adapt to what's going on. I mean, if you got the right person doing your PR and your right marketing, I mean, you can't lose.
So you've been doing like a bit of acting. Like I know, like last year, you saw a film. I guess regarding like Tukey Williams one. I know you've been doing some kind of work with that. Yeah. So I guess if you can, expand on that.
Redemption, featuring Jamie Foxx and Lynn Whitfield. It's based on Stanley Tukey Williams' life story and how everything started out with the Bloods of the Crips. He's the co-founder of the Crips.
And no one could have a better influence on gang violence or gang culture than gang members themselves, and therefore best positioned to reverse this course of violence. But we must do work. We must get out there and we must forge peace. We must stop exterminating one another. We must stop all of this madness, because at the end of the day, we have only ourselves to blame. We must have a do or die attitude, as we were as street warriors, to rebuild our culture and to create a new lasting legacy, a legacy of peace.
So I got to be a part of that, and I mean, it's an honor to be a part of history. You know, you check out the movie, I'm the Crip that actually initiates the truth between the Crips and the Bloods. Okay. So look out for that, you know what I mean?
Sometimes we walk in the flesh, which leaves us weak in the mind. Most of them lost, while some of them blinded. Couldn't pick up where I left off, they still trying to find it. Got a picture on a t-shirt. Lots of pain over the family loss. Governor don't really care about the hood or a funeral cost. Them kids I grew up with, now we killing each other. Leave a broken heart look on the face of their mothers. There's a few I'll always have love for regardless. And I'm all grown now, making the change was the hardest. It's that criminal mindset. I'm tired of sleeping in a hot vest. Wonder who can get it next.
What are some of my producers you're working with?
I'm working with a producer named Naira. I'm working with Rich Kid, has something on that. Watts, he got a couple tracks on it. You know what I mean? I got a few producers on it. Smokey, you already know what it is. Smokey has some joints on that.
Yeah.
So right now I think that's about it for now. I mean, if I remember any more right now off the top of my head, I'm gonna let you know. I mean, I've been to New York as a kid and I got a chance to see the culture in the East Coast. You know, I've been to Washington, I've been to the Dirty South. But there's something about LA, the West Coast. I think the West Coast kind of grabbed me, and I fell in love with the West Coast as soon as I went out there. I mean, mean, I used to watch a lot of movies as a kid. I used to watch Menace and Boys in the Hood, and getting a chance to actually see these places, it kind of tripped me out. Like Crenshaw, Compton, Watts, South Central, lots of swap meet. I mean, that kind of blew my mind. I got to go to Oakland, and obviously, when you get to see all these different places, it does have an effect on the way you think, because you're not thinking inside the box no more. You know, you're thinking outside of it. And I mean, it's a small world, but it's crazy. You gotta see different cultures.
See.